Hi, my name is Cold Baron. On November 11th, Bethesda will be releasing another new version of Skyrim that you can buy. Again, they call it the most definitive version of Skyrim to date. It may sound like a joke, but they are completely serious. So after a few years, we will probably get the specialiest special edition to date, then special definitive edition anniversary edition, and then 100 years later, a century edition of editions will include all previously released editions and special editions. By then, our great-grandchildren will still be waiting for Elder Scrolls 6 to be released, so they will gladly buy this edition of editions, and focus the Ocular Request will still be bugged by then. So what this most definitive edition of anniversary edition of Skyrim bring us? Well, quite a few things. It will include Skyrim Special Edition, Skyrim's DLCs of Dawnguard, Heartfire and Dragonborn, then next generation improvements for Skyrim Special Edition, all 48 previously released Creation Club items and 26 new Creation Club items. The Creation Club itself, if you somehow lived under the rock in the middle of the ocean on a distant planet in the parallel universe and never heard of it, is basically a marketplace of paid mods, made by Bethesda or by third party. These are all great quality mods, all inspected by Bethesda itself, but obviously this introduced microtransactions to Skyrim, and that sucks in general. Imagine if you've been making delicious potato salad your whole life, and suddenly you realize that there are more ingredients you can add. In general, you don't want to ruin your perfect recipe, but you are tempted to try that new stuff, so you spend more and more money every time you make a potato salad, instead of eating the one which is perfectly good. In total, Bethesda says that 74 Creation Club items will be included with Skyrim Anniversary Edition to represent over 500 new gameplay elements. Players who don't upgrade to Anniversary Edition on November 11th are also getting 4 club items for free. Let's talk about those. Free stuff is always awesome. So, you will receive the Saints and Seducers quest expansion. It revolves around the machinations of Manic Mage, who has weakened the barriers between Shivering Isles and Tamriel, allowing madness to seep through. This creation adds new summons, enemies, alchemy ingredients, a new dungeon, recruitable pets, 2 artifacts, 4 craftable armor and weapon sets, a main quest and several side quests, all themed around the Shivering Isles. Then you will get Rare Curios expansion, which adds 51 ingredients from Morrowind, Oblivion and Shivering Isles. Some of these ingredients have new effects from the previous games. It also includes poisoned apples, elite treasures and new arrows and bolts. You will get a survival mode as well, which makes Skyrim more realistic, or you know, more annoying probably, because it introduces all the basic survival techniques from survival games, such as cold, hunger, sleep, and so on. From now, on your journeys through the vast landscape of Skyrim, you will have to do all those things if you don't want to die a stupid death. Imagine, you're fighting some master vampire and all you can think is sweet rolls and potato salad. The vampire itself will become a minor inconvenience in the face of real danger. The cave vampire lives in is really cold and you don't like fighting in cold. It's not what you do anymore. You are a delicate flower. To be honest, you will become such a whiner hero, people will rather choose dragons to burn them alive instead of hearing all your complaints. And the last stuff you will get for free is fishing. You will be able to catch fish, hang their dead bodies on the wall, or imprison them in aquariums for life. This is a really nice addition, not gonna lie. When I was playing World of Warcraft some 8 years ago, I spent almost all my time fishing stuff in different locations. I love fishing in games, not fishing games, but fishing in games. It's relaxing and also a very rewarding experience, but I hate fishing in real life. My father is really good at this, but every time he took me fishing, something bad happened. For example, once I pierced my finger with a giant hook meant for catching pikes, so bad that my dad had to take a wire cutter to cut off the tip so I could remove it. You know, it's like an arrow, you can't just pull it out, it has barbs. So before that, I had to push the hook all the way through my finger, so the tip of a hook would be outside of my finger, not inside it. I hope you are eating right now. But anyway, in-game I can't hurt myself, so I love the activity. Another important question is, will this mess up all your mods? Well, probably yes. If you took your time and installed tens or even hundreds of improvements, all your hard work could be in vain. Modders expect that the Skyrim script extender, a main mod for many other Skyrim mods, will need to be updated. Developers suspect that the other plugin mods will also be affected for an unknown length of time until they can be updated. So imagine a Skyrim without, for example, Sky UI or other quality of life improving mods. So if you are afraid of your Skyrim falling apart, turn off auto updates on Steam prior to the November 11th launch. The price of the anniversary edition is not known yet. Also, it's hard to tell what it will cost if you want to upgrade your special edition to an anniversary edition. If you watch this video after November 11th, you probably know more than I do now. Thank you for watching, consider subscribing for more videos like that, and now have a nice day and I'll see you next time, bye!